The Lazy Brother. When an old merchant was dying, he gave his house to the two elder sons and their wives, and he gave each son 300 gold coins. The two elder sons said they would travel and trade, improving their fortunes. "You stay home and look after your sisters-in-law," they told the youngest, who was thoroughly lazy and spent all day sleeping on the warm stove. They took his share of money, saying, "We'll get you a cap, a sash, and red boots, and obey your sisters-in-law. Whenever any work had to be done, the two sisters-in-law would tell the young man that they would give him fried onions, soup and cider, which he enjoyed. One cold winter morning, they sent him to fetch water, promising him hot soup and onions. Grumbling, he took a pickaxe and two buckets on a pole and went to the river that was frozen. The Pike's Gift. When the sluggard struck the ice on the frozen river to draw water, he caught a large pike. "Let me go, and I'll give you anything you ask for. You only have to say, 'In the name of the pike, give me this that I like,' and it will come to you." The sluggard did not believe the pike, so he said he would first try the chant and then let it go. He asked for soup and onions, and there came a tray holding his favorite dishes. He set the pike free. He was so delighted with the chant that he asked the pike to fill up his buckets, and then they walked home on their own. When his sisters-in-law told him to chop wood, he would set the axe to work. He showed off to the people in the town, and if they stopped him, he would ask the wood pieces to thrash them. The Loving Princess. The sluggard became so famous that even the king heard of him. He sent for him, and the sisters-in-law woke him up and told him to go to meet the king. The sluggard arrived at the palace gates, sitting on the stove. When the king heard of his strange arrival, he came to the gates and asked him what he could do for him. The sluggard announced, "I thought you would give me a cap, a sash and red boots." The king and his courtiers laughed, and Princess Gapiomila, hearing all the noise, came out to see what was going on. The sluggard loved the pretty princess as soon as he saw her and whispered, "In the name of the pike, make the princess love me as I like." He returned to his stove to sleep and dream of her. Meanwhile, the princess had fallen in love with him and told her father to fetch him. The king loved his daughter dearly and decided to get her married to the sluggard. So he called a sorcerer and told him to put a spell on the sluggard and fetch him. When he came, the sorcerer put him and the princess into a large crystal casket and sent it sailing away through the sky on an enormous balloon. When the spell ended, the princess wept and begged the sluggard to bring the casket down. Using the pike's chant, the casket was brought down on a friendly island. There, the sluggard created a splendid palace for his wife, made of marble and crystal. She was very happy. But the sluggard felt ashamed of himself and wished to be a better person. He used the pike's chant to become handsome and wise. The princess missed her father. Therefore, one day, he transported them to her father's palace. Everyone was delighted, and they lived there happily ever after.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.